Hey guys, welcome back to CYBG Gaming. My name is Ade, as you already know, and today I'll be playing Call of Duty Modern Warfare Remastered, and I would also like to share the story of how I actually started playing video games. So without further ado, let me tell you guys how it all started, how the fun journey of actually getting to play video games or starting to love video games actually started. Okay, so basically, I think I actually started playing video games when I was about 5 years old or thereabout, although I actually never had any console of my own. To be honest, I never had a console of my own. The first video game I actually played then was on Sega. Yeah, I actually played Sega. That was my first video game console or something. That's if they call it a console or anything. I played Sega, and it actually has a cartridge that has Contra on it. And if most of you, the old, the 90s children, would know what Contra is, or would know what it is. I actually don't know what Contra it actually is, but it is what actually made me fall in love with video games up until now. Can't actually remember what Contra it was, as I said earlier, but trust, I was so amused the day I played it, to be honest. Like, I was like, I'm sure when I was young, that was what would have been going on inside my head. To be honest, I never felt what I was just like playing to have fun. But the game caught me up when I was like very young, at the age of 5, imagine. At the age of 5, you guys would be wondering, how would you even know how you felt? Obviously, because I couldn't even break any level at that age. But to be honest, I really, really was like, I'm sure, by then the feeling would be like, oh Jesus, let me play more, you know. Anyways, I only played that game at my uncle's house in Nigeria, because I lived in Nigeria for quite some time. I played it at my uncle's house, and I would always actually ask my dad to allow me go to my uncle's house every weekend, every other weekend. My dad didn't know why I was actually asking to go there, but happily, it would allow me to go there without knowing what I was going there to do. But down inside my dark mind, then I was going there for Sega. And anytime I actually go to my uncle's weekend, in my uncle's place over the weekend, and he doesn't bring out the Sega, I'll be like really, really furious, because he doesn't like leave it out during the week. He takes it back into his room or to keep it somewhere, because I think I was at his place during the week just because of Sega also sometime, and I found out he doesn't actually put it outside. And basically, as I was saying, my dad would actually allow me to go there every weekend. When I found out that it wasn't like everyday stuff, so I decided to like go there every weekend. But sure, my dad would actually allow me go there every weekend. It went on like that for a few years, till about, I was about, was it 11 years old? Yeah, it was about when I was about 11 years old. So I've been going to my uncle's house for about six years, imagine. About 6 years, going to play Sega. Because my parents couldn't afford to get me my own console. And then, it's Nigeria, we're not like connected to the world, so basically it's only the rich kids that only have video game consoles or that know about the new consoles. So basically, at about 2004 December, this wonderful woman that I call my mom bought me the PSP 2000 on release day back in 2004 December. Like, I got the game, I was like, jeez. Before I actually got the PSP, I think then in 2004, as I said, before I got the PSP, over the 6 years of playing Sega, I actually go to video game shops, yeah? I go to video game shops where you pay to play video games. I watch adults play the PS2 in Nigeria, especially the winning 11, even though what the winning 11 is. Jeez, the Konami winning 11s. I watch adults play the winning 11s in Nigeria, because when adults are playing, you dare not say you want to play. Because if you actually say that you want to play, the only thing you would hear is not just sorry you can't play. You'd actually receive a very heavy slap that will land on your face. And that slap would actually make you feel like a concussion grenade exploded right in front of you in court. Like, to be honest, I'm not actually joking. They would just dizzy the slap from anywhere. You wouldn't even know where the hand came from. Anyways, I actually remember playing the demo disc that actually came with my PSP 2000 then for about 2 to 3 years, because my dad would make me play 2 days, play it for another 2 days, keep it. Okay, I played the demo disc, as I was saying, I played the demo disc for 2 to 3 years, but because I couldn't afford a game disc then. I had to play the demo disc. All I had to do was play demo disc. See all the games I can play when I start having money, or when my mom asked me, okay, do you have any games to play? But unfortunately, the date for my mom to ask me, do you have any money to play, didn't come. So basically, I was lucky that at some point in my life, I actually started receiving cash gifts on my birthday, not actual physical gifts. So there was a day, and like my uncle gave me about 22,000 naira to actually use for my birthday, and I actually asked one of my neighbors on that day to take me to a game shop, not knowing what I wanted to do, until I asked for Wipeout Puree, or Pure, if that's how they call it. If you guys actually remember Wipeout, I really played Wipeout. Okay, I went to the game shop, bought Wipeout Pure, because it was one of the games on the demo disc that I really love. I liked it. I played Wipeout for months until I could save up to buy a used Pro Evolution Soccer 6. What the heck? Imagine a used Pro Evolution Soccer 6 in 2012 or something. In 2005. Is it? Yeah, I think it was in 2005, 2006 that I bought Pro Evolution Soccer 6. Not even a flipping new disc. I bought a used Pro Evolution Soccer 6. I played that game for years. It got to a point when I asked myself, why would my mom even buy the game and not include any disc? Because you know when you've actually been playing a single game over and over and over and over, and you're like, you get tired of it. I'm like, geez, why didn't this woman just buy the disc and she bought just the console? When I was actually thinking of this, I went back to the game shop to actually see if I could actually buy some new cheap games. Then I met a guy, miraculously, came out from nowhere. He actually works in the shop that I'm actually trying to buy the console for, because they repair game console from the in the shop where I was trying to buy the game disc from. So basically, this guy walked up to me, saw me that I'm really young and he's very friendly. One day, if you actually find my channel, you know that I'm talking about him. Lamide, anywhere you are there, you are like the big boss. So basically, he offered to perform some magic, some Harry Potter stuff on my PSP, and I was able to install loads of games for a cheap amount. It was insane how much games I can actually install on my PSP, and I can actually copy them on my computer, keep them, and put another game to actually save storage. I actually installed different games for years, like years. So basically, I think I met him back in 2007. So 2007 to 2009, when everything started, like I should actually be getting serious with my life in 2009. That was about when I started reducing the amount of games I play on my PSP. So here comes 2009, when I was preparing for my GCSEs. Then I was in, I think, SS3 in Nigeria. They call it SS3 in Nigeria. I was actually preparing for my GCSEs. I remember I and a few friends would go to video game stores. Video gaming shop where we actually pay to play. Remember when I was younger, we only watch adults play them. But now we can actually go to those shops and pay to play them. To be honest, in that year, I am about 70% sure none of I and my friends prepared properly the way we should for the exam. Like, we played a lot of Winning 11 and Pro Evolution Soccer those days. Like, we would just go to the gaming shop, ask the shop manager or shop director or shop supervisor to let's play for 30 minutes or something. I think we pay about 20 pence to play the game. To be honest, I'm not actually sure how much it is in pound. So, but you actually pay to play per minute, not per hour, because you can actually sit there for hours. There's a lot of people that want to play, and people that actually go to the gaming shop to actually play career mode. That's how insane it is. So basically, I remember we'll just go there, we'll play the games. Played so many games, and basically we should actually have been preparing for exams, but no, we're playing video games. That same year, I remember actually taking my PSP to school, and the teacher that prevented me from actually achieving an A in chemistry, because all I stared at in class was a fat butt, took my game over the weekend. To be honest, it was crazy. Chemistry, yes, auntie, I love you. She actually, I basically stared at her butt in class, because she's like light skin, big body, big ass, tiny boobies. Like, she's... Oh, okay, sorry. Children, close your ears, please. Thank you. She's, like, dumb hot, to be honest. So, she was the one that prevented me from achieving an A in chemistry because I would only stay at her button class. So, she took my game on the weekend, took it home. On a Friday, she took it home. She seized it from me on a Friday, took it home over the weekend, and her husband played it. Am I actually sure that it was her husband that played it? Yeah, she just got married. We all know about that in school. To be honest, she just got, like, well, who else would actually play my game if not for her husband, because she doesn't know how to actually operate it. So as I was saying, when she actually took the game home, I was like filming over the weekend, because that would be the first time I and my game would sleep under this different roof since 2004, and I'm talking about 2009. After 5 years of I and my game's union, someone just walked out from nowhere and took it home. So it was like filming over the weekend. So then come this really Sunday, yeah, because our church is like close by to mine, and she called me. Did she call me actually? I think she called me because she had my number. She was actually my private teacher also. She called me. She was like, okay, Wally, come and pick your phone come and pick your game at my church, because my church is not far from our church is not far from my house. So I was like, after my home church service, I would come. Basically, I got it on a Sunday. That was what didn't make it stretch all through the weekend. So I actually charged it on Sunday. I still went back to school on Monday with it. That's how insane I am with my game then. So basically, let's get back to my GCSE. So then comes June 2009, when time to write the GCSE is quite upon us. So basically, I and my silly friends had an exam for 2 p.m. This crazy day was... I think we were actually meant to write biology or something that day. We actually had an exam to write to 2 p.m. that day. Would you actually believe I and my silly friends were at a gaming shop paying to play a game at 12:30? It was actually crazy that when we were playing, we had to ask each other, like, don't we have an exam to write today? Like, isn't that stupid of us to ask? Like, some stupid question we shouldn't have been asking each other before. Like, we know we are writing an exam today, so why are you still asking me that kind of thing? Anyways, before you guys ask, we passed our GCSE with good colors, only that the colors were not flying. We were all working. Yeah, they were all working, the colors are not flying. So anyways, did we actually get to the exam all late? No, we didn't, but we only revised for 15 minutes instead of, because we actually left the game shop about 1:30 to get to school, and it was about 15 minutes roughly. So basically, after the exam and all this stuff, I actually got a nickname from school then before actually leaving my junior students actually called me PS100 because of my love for PlayStation. Well, my parents were unable to buy me a console, so than the PSP. So I think, and I don't actually justify the nickname, even though I play PlayStation alone in the game shops, which was the only console we have in Nigeria. Okay, so a few months after my exams and the results came out, my mom was so impressed about the results that she actually got me my first computer. I flipping loved my Toshiba Satellite. The 17 or 19 inch screen, the stainless speakers, and the full keyboard. If you actually know that Toshiba computer, shout me out. I'd really love to buy it off you if you have it. I'd really love to buy it off you. So because I actually loved the computer because of the iSpec it had, and then I was actually, the level of love I have for this computer would actually make me clean it every morning if I actually use it. The only thing I didn't do was to wash it with soap and water. Please, children, or younger people, or younger folks, don't do that, because your computer is gonna crack. It's gonna, like, just get fried. Anyways, I love that computer to the extent that I would have actually loved to wash it with soap and water. And that computer actually marked the beginning of me gaming on a sensible level. A friend of mine gave me an installation disc for Need for Speed was 110, I think. Yeah, back in 2010. This is about 2010-ish. Okay, so because I was actually going, I was at NIIT, like a programming firm or something in Nigeria, trying to learn programming, but instead I was installing games on my computer. So basically, A friend of mine actually gave me the most wanted, Need for Speed Most Wanted game, not the 2010 version, the 2005 one, the blacklist one. So basically, this guy actually installed it for me, showed me how to install video games, which was the first time I learned. So basically, I would always smash my cosmets in NIT on the LAN play. I was like wicked with the game. In fact, I mastered the game to the point at which I finished the story mode in just 6 hours. Like, it was crazy. Got all the pink slips for the blacklist driver's cars. My best car was the Skyline. Like, I loved the car. I loved it. Went about a year or two on PC gaming. FIFA 13, like, was the last game I actually played on PC. Like, I played FIFA 13. I was like, I actually bought a USB controller then. Like, jeez. I love FIFA. I actually smash people too. I smash a lot of people. But I played FIFA 13 on PC, and FIFA 14 actually came out. I think I played FIFA 13 on PC, but not on my first PC. It was on my second or third computer. I couldn't play, was it FIFA 13 or FIFA 12? To be honest, I'm not sure about what FIFA I actually played, but I know that one FIFA was the last FIFA I played on PC, and it actually mashed. It was the first time I played FIFA, and I loved it, to be honest. And since then, I never stopped playing FIFA. I actually left it for I left PES for FIFA. So basically, then come 2014 when I moved to England fully, then I got my very first console, which was the Xbox 360. Around July, I played COD 3. Yeah, I think it was Call of Duty 3 on the console for the very, very first time. I've played it before my PC. It was the very, very first time I played COD 3. Yeah. And I think I played GTA 5 then, story mode. I smashed the story mode. It was very easy. So basically, for the very first time I played GTA 5 in my life, I think that was after a year. That was a year after GTA 5 got released. That was when I played GTA 5 story mode. But basically, I think I got my, yeah, as I said, I got my Xbox 360 July, and I bought my PlayStation 2014 November. I think I bought it November, I think it was a day or 2 days before the release of I actually bought it September, and I bought my Xbox 360 around April. Yeah, I bought my Xbox 360 around April, and I bought my PS4 just before FIFA 15 actually released. And I got FIFA 15, Destiny, and I pre-ordered Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. Like, it was insane. Advanced Warfare actually introduced me to proper multiplayer session. I loved Destiny for some time, and I actually got tired of it because of the internet connection and blah 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 blah. It was annoying. Why? Advanced Warfare actually introduced me to proper multiplayer session. Never in my life have I actually played someone in the room. Someone as in played against someone else that is not beside me physically. So it was weird for me to actually start playing this game. Like, they're weird. So basically, I enjoyed it. I didn't make my life be like okay, because I never had it when I was young, which has stopped me from having fun now. Like, I developed myself to actually learning to play COD multiplayer. It was very fun. Like, trust me, it was fun. So basically, I think that was actually when I actually started playing fully. At that point, and I was actually better on COD. I was actually really good on COD. I was really surprised how good I was, because I had these Nigerian friends that would play on and on and on and on and on. And I didn't actually know what actually made me not too good now, because my COD experience or my COD style and my COD achievement is like bare down the drain. It's like really, really annoying. I don't know why I actually play as if I'm dead now. Anyways, let's move on with the story. I really wish that I can actually visit some games on PC, but to be honest, my PSP 2000 actually made everything possible for me. My PSP 2000, before you guys actually ask me, I didn't sell my PSP. It's still alive in my bag, in my room. Anyways, I really love the game. Anyways, guys, thank you so much for listening to a young annoying dude that his English is not even above par level talk or tell you the story of how we actually started playing video games. And thank you for actually watching my very, very annoying and shitty Call of Duty Remastered gameplay. Please make sure to like this video, subscribe for more, check out my previous video, ask your friend to check out my previous video before actually checking my video, my recent video, and ask them to subscribe when you are subscribing so that it will be fun. You know, it's a trend, subscribing to CYBG Gaming. Anyways, watch out for more videos from CYBG Gaming. I remain your boy Ade, and I will see you guys on the next one. Ahimi. Bro, Ibrahimi. Ibrahimi. That was wonderful. That was wonderful. All the way to the other side of the book. Of the third floor. Okay. Oh shit. Thank you, Smiley. Okay, Nick. We're gonna get to it.